Hello learners, today we will look at the topic, the history of English literature. We will also look at the period in the history of English language and literature called the Early English period. The period which extends from 450 to 1066 is called the Early English period. Before discussing the Early English period in detail, we should know what a history of English literature is. Naturally, there arises the question, what is the definition of a history of English literature? Most presumably, it seems hardly worthwhile to propound this question, because the answer to it is very simple. A history of English literature is simply the chronological study, the chronological account of the books and the men and women who wrote them. In a rough way, this definition is all right so far as it goes. But in fact, this definition is too vague and it does not go far enough. It will be better for us to know what a history of English literature really involves. We cannot think of a book without thinking of its writer. Every book takes us back behind its writer. Every book is the product of the genius of the author, and it embodies the particular thoughts and feelings of the writer. In matters of English literature, we must fix attention upon the personalities of those men and women by whom this literature has been made. Every writer brings at least one new thing into his writing. Therefore, a history of English literature is concerned to indicate the value and nature of the particular contribution which each writer has made into that literature. However, a mere list of the writers and their books do not constitute the history of English literature, or literature as a whole grows and changes from generation to generation. In tracing this growth, a history must show the place which each writer occupies in it and his relations with those who went before and his relations with those who came after him. Literature, as a matter of fact, originates and flourishes from time to time and from generation to generation. As a result, the taste of literature of one age may vary from the taste of literature of another age. Every age bears its particular kind of interest, modes of feeling and thinking about the varied aspects of life. Age, environment, political situation, economic condition, etc. have a greater impact on every writer's mind, on everyone's mind. And the writer, with his charisma, is sure to report them into his writing and thus makes the people conscious of all these things. Now we are in a position to realize what it is that the history of English literature undertakes to do. Its main object is to trace the progress of the literature through all its transformations from age to age and to explain the changes which have taken place in its matter, form and spirit. The history of English literature has different periods. Let us now look at the early English period. What was once called the Anglo-Saxon literature is regarded as an early form of English literature. The early English literature is also called the Old English literature. According to this conception, English literature did not begin with Chaucer. Chaucer was a 14th century poet. He is called the morning star of English literature. He is also called the father of modern English poetry. However, English literature began far back with the beginning of the history of the people on the continent of Europe. It began in the 5th century when Jutes, Angles and Saxons came to England and started their reign. And this period ended in 1066 with Norman conquest. Norman conquest means the conquest of England by Duke William of Normandy. Normandy is a province of France. Originally, the name Anglo-Saxon denotes two of the three Germanic tribes, Jutes, Angles, and Saxons, who left their homes on the shores of the North Sea and Baltic and came to England to conquer and colonize the distant Britain. The name Saxon suggests the swordsman, and from this name we may judge something about the temper of the hardy fighters who preceded the Angles into Britain. The Angles were the most numerous conquering tribes, and from their name, Angles, their new homeland was named Angloland. By gradual changes, it became Angliland and then England. The literature of Anglo-Saxon period or Old English period is divided into two groups, poetry and prose. Poetry made its appearance before prose. The Anglo-Saxon poetry falls into two categories. The Anglo-Saxon secular poetry and the Anglo-Saxon Christian poetry. Whitsitt is the earliest specimen of the Anglo-Saxon secular poem. The alternative name of Whitsitt is Far Wanderer. The author and the date of composition of Whitsitt are unknown to us. The theme of the poem is not very remarkable. It describes the experience of a minister who visited a lot of places. It also describes the experience of the men and manners of those places. Thus, Whitsitt became a far wanderer, a great traveler. Then, the complaint of Dior is another example of the Anglo-Saxon secular poem. The author and the date of composition of the complaint of Dior are also unknown to us. Dior is also a minister, but he is not a wanderer. About this poem, we can say that Dior was the great favorite to a lord, but his position was supplanted by his rival poet, well skilled in songs, who removed his favor from the lord. After having this bitter experience, he consoles himself by remembering the sufferings of the men and women who suffered more than himself. Beowulf is another example of the Anglo-Saxon poetry. The author and date of composition of Beowulf are not also known to us. It is the oldest epic. It is the oldest surviving English epic. It is a poem of nearly 3,000 lines. It is not possible to give a brief synopsis of the poem. In outline, we can say that Bjulp sails to Denmark with a youth gang of warriors and rids the king of Denmark of a monster named Gindre. The mother of Gindrel sought the revenge of the death of her son, but while taking revenge upon the death of her son, she also met the same fate. Bjulp was rewarded when he returned his own homeland. He became the king of his own country, and after reigning his country prosperously for long 40 years, he kills a monster, and in fighting with the monster he received a fatal wound. And later on, he is attuned to his injury. The poem concludes with the funeral ceremony of this dead king. Then let us discuss the Anglo-Saxon Christian poetry. The character of English people was profoundly modified by their conversion to Christianity. The Anglo-Saxon people were the rudest people, but by becoming Christians, they came into a civilized world. At that time, saws and monasteries were the centers of education and instruction and art. The Roman saws played an important role in making the people, in making the rude people civilized and moderate. However, Cædmon is the first Christian poet, English Christian poet. His remarkable works are The Fall of Angels, The Harrowing Hell, and The Temptations. Another Anglo-Saxon Christian poet is the Venerable Bede. He is the first English historian. His remarkable work is Ecclesiastical History of the People of England. Another Anglo-Saxon Christian poet is Cynewulf. His remarkable works are Juliana, Onyx, The Life of the Spirits, etc. As per the nature of Anglo-Saxon literature, we can say that this literature was written by the clerks or clergy who lived in the convent and read Bible. In short, the Anglo-Saxon literature, English literature, A mongrel has a mongrel type of philosophy. However, Latin became the background of Anglo-Saxon literature. Dear students, I think you have enjoyed this session well. No more today. Thank you so much.